And now I would like to please welcome Student Council President James Bedingfield.
Please join me in saying the Pledge of Allegiance and then remain standing for our national anthem. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Now please welcome graduating senior Paul Sanford. Valedictorian and class president of the class of 2015, President Nicholas Stevens will now address the class. Check, check.
All right. So my task today is to relate to all of you the 4 years that make up a high school experience, but I've decided that I really can't do that because it's impossible. We all have drastically different experiences here at Reading Memorial High School, and in fact, no two experiences here at RMHS are the same. So I'm just gonna forget about high school today, and I'm gonna talk about something that we all have experience with, but it's not high school. And some of us have definitely done it, some of us have seen our parents do it, or our neighbors, and that is mowing the lawn. You know, cutting the grass. So the metaphysics of mowing the lawn. Why do we do that? Why do we mow the lawn? Why does the grass need to be cut? And why does almost every single household own a lawnmower? We do it for aesthetics, don't we? So that the lawn looks good, it feels good, and every single blade is the same uniform height. Uniformity. We do it for uniformity, because uniformity is supposed to be beautiful. But while we view cutting the lawn as a productive activity, it really is counterproductive. We plant, water, fertilize, weed, irrigate, in all ways nurture our lawns so that they may grow. And then, before they can grow, to fulfill their lifelong purpose of sprouting seeds and creating new grass, we chop them down, we castrate them. And also our lawns look nice and neat without a single blade out of place. Now, classmates, we are those blades of grass. At first, we are helped to grow. We are fed, encouraged, educated. But then we start to become unique, to look different, to think different, and to dream different. And it is then that the iron blade that our society can at so many times be chops us and our dreams down for the sake of conformity. And we're part of that society, so what we have to realize is that, yes, we all grow together, but we grow at different speeds, and we grow to different heights. And yes, we become green together, but in different shades and at different times. And most importantly, that yes, we all, every single one of us, strives to sprout seeds, the seeds of ideas, and to spread them throughout our community and our world. So don't let that iron blade take away your growth or the growth of your neighbor. Don't let the intrinsic tendency to conform decapitate your dreams, stunt your growth, or restrict your individuality. It is a far more beautiful thing to see individuality thrive than to see the great platitude of conformity that the lawn represents. So grow as tall as you want. Spread your ideas like dandelion fuzz on the wind, and be who you want to be. Congratulations, class of 2015. May you grow tall and strong, and may individuality live long.
Salutatorian of the class of 2015, Alexandra Sahajan, will now address the class.
Mr. Bacher, Dr. Doherty, faculty, administration, families, friends, and fellow graduates, welcome to the Reading Memorial High School Class of 2015 graduation ceremony. I am both honored and humbled to stand before you as class salutatorian, a term that until a few days ago, was as unfamiliar to me as the high school was when we first came here almost 4 years ago. And as I stand here, I am reminded of something author Neil Donald Walsh once said: life begins at the end of your comfort zone. It's important to know the boundaries of our comfort zones. Something outside of mine is talking to people I don't know. Giving this speech right now also qualifies. As I look around at everyone here, I see more than 300 of my peers. I see friends, I see classmates, I see teammates, but I also see some people that I have never talked to, people who I've attended school with for at least 4 years. So what about you? How many of our classmates have you talked to? Hopefully most of them. Next year, no matter where we end up, we will be surrounded by hundreds, maybe even thousands of new people. How many of them will we engage? If you are like me and talking to new people isn't comfortable for you, do it as much as you can, because meeting and talking to new people is very important. We never know who we are going to meet, what we may learn from them, or how they will affect our lives. There are essentially an unlimited number of people for us to encounter in our lifetime, so why not try to talk to as many as we can? However, if you are not like me and you love engaging new people, then find what's outside of your comfort zone and practice it as much as you can. Many of us have done this in high school, like trying a new sport, performing on stage, or taking a difficult class. We must continue exploring what's unfamiliar to us and continue taking risks so that we may expand our comfort zones. And like Mr. Walsh reminds us, doing things outside of our comfort zones is when our lives begin. And now that we are finally graduating from high school, we get the chance to create our own lives. For the past 12 plus years, most of us have been going to the same schools, in the same town, with the same people, and now it's over. This is the first time that we get to choose where we are going to go and what we are going to do next. Some of us are going to schools in New England, some are going to schools across the country, while others are getting jobs. Maybe for some of us, these paths seem outside of our comfort zones. Or maybe others can't wait to move on. Whichever it is, let's make the most of what we choose to do, because that's the big difference. It's our choice. From this moment on, we are in control of our lives, and control means responsibility. We have the opportunity and the responsibility to make great lives for ourselves, to make ourselves happy, and to make our lives what we want them to be. And speaking of responsibility, we not only have the responsibility to enjoy our own lives, but we also have the responsibility to help others around us enjoy their lives. President Reagan once said, "You can't help everyone, but everyone can help someone." I believe that helping those in need is one of the main things that the Reading school system has worked hard to teach us. Many of the wonderful clubs we've grown or started at RMHS have left positive impacts on countless people. So let's continue to expand upon the great lessons we've learned here and make a positive change in the world. So as I wrap up, I would like to ask, what will we, the class of 2015, do to make a difference? I bet it will be something awesome, and I look forward to seeing what we do with our futures. So congratulations, class of 2015, on a great 4 years of high school, and good luck in the future. Thank you.
The RMHS singers, under the direction of Ms. Kristen Killian, will perform Let Your Heart Be Stayed. Please welcome our principal, Mr. Adam Bacher.
Thank you, Jimmy. Thank you again for joining us this afternoon in celebrating the class of 2015. I would be remiss if I did not first take the necessary time to acknowledge a number of important people who have contributed in making this special day possible. Please join me in acknowledging these individuals and the groups with applause for their efforts. For the beautiful musical accompaniment, we thank the RMHS band conducted by Mr. Dave Bunton and Mr. Joe Mulligan, and the RMHS singers under the direction of Ms. Kristen Killian. For their participation as class marshals representing the class of 2016, we thank student leaders Ellie Wilson and Parker Webb. For the coordination of today's graduation ceremony, we thank RMHS teacher Mr. Chuck Strout and secretaries Ms. Mary Ellen Begonis, Ms. Valerie O'Brien, Ms. Pat Shields, and Ms. Carmen O'Rourke. For the preparation of the facility and school grounds, we thank head custodian Mo Hillis and his custodial team and facilities director Kelly Colon and her team. Lastly, for their generous donation of bottled water for staff and the graduates, we thank Reading Cooperative Bank. Next, I would also like to acknowledge and thank several groups of people who have helped shape the educational experience that has been the foundation for today's graduates. For their leadership, we thank and recognize school committee members Mr. Charles Robinson, Chair, Ms. Jean Borowski, Vice Chair, Ms. Linda Snow-Doxer, Ms. Julianne Joyce, Mr. Gary Nyan, and Ms. Elaine Webb. We also thank longtime former school committee member and chair Mr. Chris Caruso, whose son Josh is graduating today and who will assist in conferring the diplomas in a little while. For their support and vision, we thank our district leadership team, Superintendent Dr. John Doherty, Assistant Superintendent Mr. Craig Martin, Director of Finance Ms. Martha Seiber, Director of Student Services Ms. Carolyn Wilson, and Director of Human Resources Ms. Michaela Saunders. For their leadership and guidance throughout our graduates' younger formative years, we thank our elementary and middle school principals, Ms. Kathy Giles, Ms. Heather Leonard, Ms. Joanne King, Mr. Eric Sprung, Ms. Karen Feeney, Mr. Doug Lyons, and Ms. Sarah Marchant, as well as their dedicated staff. For their constant support, belief, dedication, and commitment to the achievement of the class of 2015, we extend a special thank you to the educators, counselors, and staff of Reading Memorial High School. Their tireless efforts day in and day out, working alongside of you seniors, has helped you to reach personal and academic levels you may previously have thought not possible. For their dedication in shaping the successful activities of the class of 2015, we thank our hardworking senior class advisors and teachers, Mr. Frank Bono and Ms. Beth Dalby. For their efforts in overseeing and celebrating the success and well-being of the class of 2015 over the years, we thank assistant principals Mr. Tom Zaya and Ms. Laura Olson. You guys didn't think I would forget Mr. Scarpino, did you? And of course, I would also like to extend a special, special thank you for the guidance, energy, spirit, and dedication of longtime assistant principal Mr. Michael Scarpino. Mr. Scarpino, who is retiring after almost two decades of unbridled enthusiasm for the young adults of Reading Memorial High School, Mr. Scarpito has been the voice and caretaker of RMHS for all these years, and now with you, the class of 2015, he begins his next chapter as well. And lastly, we would like to honor and recognize the many families, friends, and mentors here today who have been such an integral part of these outstanding graduates' lives, day in and day out over the past 18 years. Without the constant commitment to your children's lives and to the excellence of Reading as a community, the collective achievement we see today would not have been possible. It is this topic of community that I would like to reflect upon with you seniors, the class of 2015 today. To a new principal, it has been absolutely amazing to witness the power of such an interconnected community. The strength of such committed parents and of such an invested town is that the majority of you have heard a steady stream of encouraging words and high aspirations since the time you began going to school more than 12 years ago. You have been celebrated, recognized, protected, respected, and held in the highest regard as this community's most prized possession, its children, and the recurring promise that accompanies its young people to do amazing things and to surpass the success of the parents and adults who work so hard to cherish them. As a result of this community commitment to your success, it is no wonder that your accomplishments as a class are far more than many other schools and towns that may lack this impressive level of shared responsibility to its young people. Your family's common efforts to get to know one another and to work together to create loving and supportive environments have created a safety net empowering so many of you to take on new challenges and to reach high without fearing failure, but rather instead to celebrate the journey regardless of the outcome. As a result of this support and encouragement, it is no surprise that you as a class are such a positive and thoughtful group of young adults, eager to help others and eager to make a good impression on those you encounter. Over and over again this year, I hear educators and parents, coaches and administrators, community members and neighboring communities say about you, the class of 2015, they're just such a nice group of kids. And ladies and gentlemen, I gotta tell you, I would certainly have to agree. One might think that a potential drawback of such a closely knit community like this class would be a reluctance to welcome outsiders or new ideas or to be overly absorbed with themselves. But I can tell you firsthand, nothing could be further from the truth. Right from my first interaction with many of you at this year's freshman orientation in your role as upper connectors, more than 100 of you took the time from your summer fun and welcomed your terrified freshman peers to RMHS, making them quickly feel at home in your school community. Then, with a new principal, your third in 4 years, rather than being skeptical and distant, you warmly received me with welcoming smiles and willing assistance, and showed me why the class of 2015 is such a nice bunch of kids. In fact, even when challenging topics like cap and gown colors came up, and the millionth survey was administered, you guys politely voiced your feelings in an honest but respectful manner, working together as a community to arrive at an outcome we could all be proud of. When tragedy swept through our school, following the loss of junior classmate Nate Dwerin in December, you guys supported and looked after your fellow students and adults to help us cope with our loss. In fact, you may or may not know that it was actually two anonymous members of this selfless class, and you know who you are, who inspired us all during those difficult days with an amazing act of random kindness, posting beautiful notes of encouragement on every student's locker, on every teacher's door, just to help our community heal. Similarly, when classmates and staff and even a rival Middlesex League school lost loved ones of their own, this class was there to support them as a community of caring and deeply committed young adults. Of course, this class also knows how to celebrate each other as a community. When the girls' hockey team played for the state championship, the class of 2015 poured into the garden for some early morning hockey to urge their classmates on to a thrilling victory. You seniors also helped us usher in the Victory Bell era, providing us with a long list of academic, athletic, artistic, and service accomplishments that were celebrated by the RMHS community first thing on many mornings. And lastly, who could forget the celebrations of the past few weeks with all the various senior events? Senior prom at the House of Blues, boat cruise in the Boston Harbor, the all-nighter, and the hypnotist. The class of 2015 community is kind, smart, talented, funny, and can dance too. Who knew? Fortunately, however, I politely had to decline all of your requests to demonstrate dance moves of my own. Sorry guys, I do know my limitations. Yup, this group is indeed just a really nice group of kids with a whole lot of talent and with a whole Reading community of family, friends, neighbors, and educators urging them on to even greater heights in the years to come. You have the confidence and the support of all of us and of one another to accomplish anything that you put your mind to. Class of 2015, congratulations on this special day that you sit together with your classmates for one last ceremonial occasion. Thank you for making me feel so at home here at RMHS. And thank you for teaching me what Reading Memorial High School's community is all about. I only wish that I had the chance to know you a little bit longer. We can't wait to hear all that you will do in the future and of all that you will become. In the famous words of beloved assistant principal, Mr. Mike Scarpito, you guys are good ones. Thank you, everyone. And now I am proud to recognize some exemplary members of the class of 2015. I would first like to recognize this year's National Merit Commended Students. The following students placed among the top 5% of more than 1.5 million students who took the 2013 PSATs. Please stand when your name is called. Audience, we ask that you hold your applause until all scholars have been named. Jenna Choi, Julia Driscoll, Matthew Ferraro, Ryan Friedman, Allie Gerard, Aiden Kolnick, Emily Lalasher, Sean McCubbin, Kate McNosa, Shannon Siegel, Catherine Smith, Nicholas Stevens, Ian Tucker, Rebecca Wandell, and Stephen West. I would also like to recognize our National Merit finalist, Peter Satterthwaite. Peter, please stand and join us in being recognized. Peter has exceeded the criteria of the National Merit Commended Students based upon outstanding academic achievement, PSAT scores, and SAT scores, and is now considered a National Merit Scholar. Please join me once again in recognizing these students. You may now be seated. Thank you, guys. And now I would like to invite advisors to the class of 2015, Ms. Beth Dalby and Mr. Frank Bono, and Director of Guidance, Ms. Lena Williams, to join me in the presentation of awards. A plaque hangs on Main Street at RMHS to recognize the accomplishments of four notable seniors each year. This year, the following exemplary students will have their names added to the list. This year's valedictorian award goes to Nicholas Stevens. This year's salutatorian award goes to Alexandra Sahagin. This year's leadership award goes to Jack Bloom. This year's service award goes to Mary Catherine O'Meara. I would now like to introduce Guidance Director Ms. Lena Williams, who will announce the remaining scholastic honors.
It is my pleasure to announce the following awards. The English Department Award is given by the teachers of the English Department to a graduate who most diligently has sought the realization of excellence. This award goes to Emily LaLasher. The Foreign Language Department Award, given by the teachers of the Foreign Language Department to a graduate in recognition of scholarship and academic excellence in foreign language. This award goes to Alyssa Bogosian. The Math Department Award is given by the teachers of the Math Department in recognition of scholarship and achievement in mathematics. This award goes to Joseph DiBacco. Award is given by the teachers of the Science Department in recognition of scholarship and achievement in science. This award goes to Althea Wolf. Department Award is given by the teachers of the Social Studies Department in recognition of scholarship and excellence in social studies. This award goes to Nick Stevens. The Wellness Department Award is given in recognition of effort, attitude, and excellence in the field of health and wellness. This award goes to Colin Hetherington. The Band Parents Award in memory of Joseph McGillicuddy is presented to members of the RMHS Marching Band who have shown excellent musicianship, leadership, character, and concern for others. The four recipients of this award are Natalie Giuliano, Carrie Bowe, Andrew Costello, and Bailey Lanzalotta. A former drummer who left his mark of courage and spirit on the RMHS band program is presented to a member of the band program who has shown musical talent, leadership, character, and a love of family and friends. This award goes to Ryan Janeskis. The Class of 64 Award to honor those who fought in the Vietnam War is given to an outstanding member of the RMHS community who has demonstrated excellence of scholarship, character, and personality. This award goes to James Bedingfield. The Scott Connolly Memorial Award is given to deserving graduates who are hardworking, tenacious, friendly, respectful, and compassionate towards others. This award goes to Mackenzie Regan. RMHS Award is given to outstanding graduate for integrity and sincerity in the community in track and field. This award goes to Matthew Dynan. The Nathaniel G. Hill Award is given to a worthy student for his or her further education, be it college, junior college, or trade school. This award goes to Nicholas Roach. The James E. Kleppis Junior Science Award is given to a college or university-bound RMHS student who has displayed an interest in and aptitude for the field of science. This award goes to Kate Magnosa. Memorial Scholarship is given in memory of Dennis Lehane, class of 1992, to a senior who will be attending a college or university and who has displayed exemplary courage, determination, and team spirit while participating in track, football, or both while at RMHS. This award goes to Carter Swade. Teacher is presented to a deserving member of the graduating class advancing to a college education. This award goes to Megan Barry. The Florence G. Nichols Scholarship presented to a girl in the senior class moving on to advanced education who has demonstrated great mental and physical ability as well as leadership. This award goes to Jamie Melly. The William E. Enslow Scholarship recognizes a senior who has consistently held himself or herself to the highest standards of excellence in the areas of leadership, community service, and drama. This student exemplifies the true spirit of the Reading Memorial High School Drama Club and demonstrates a passionate dedication to theater arts. This award goes to Sabine Michaud. Enslow Drama Scholarship is awarded to a senior who has developed a passion for theater arts during her time at the Reading Public Schools. The recipient embodies a belief in collaboration and teamwork, as well as an appreciation for the visual, auditory, artistic, and communication skills vital to the presentation of live theater. This award goes to Julia Popkin. Memorial Scholarship is given in memory of Robert Patterson, industrial arts teacher at RMHS for many years, by the Student Council to members of the senior class for service, leadership, and contributions to the RMHS community. The two recipients of this award are Alyssa Bogosian and Kate Magnosa. Exemplary Character Award is presented to members of the graduating class who have made special contributions to the high school community. There are 10 students receiving this award, so please hold your applause until all names have been read. The recipients of this award are Stephanie Cohen, Eric Safarian, Nina Lukens, Abigail Alardi, Megan O'Brien, Ryan Friedman, Jonna Lee, Liam Gillen Hughes, Charlie Kellogg, and Allie Gerard. The Althea M. Russell Scholarship recognizes a senior in the top 10% of the graduating class who has demonstrated academic excellence, generosity, selflessness, and a spirit of leadership at Reading Memorial High School and in our community. The award goes to Megan Littlehale. The School Committee Prize is presented to a member of the graduating class in recognition of outstanding scholarship, character, and personality. This award goes to Jonah Ogburn. The S. Edwin Shin Memorial Award is presented to a graduate outstanding in instrumental music and science. This award goes to Jenna Choi. The Arthur L. Spencer Memorial Award is given in memory of an outstanding member of the Foreign Language Department to a senior who has excelled in foreign language with a special emphasis in Latin. This award goes to Peter Satterthwaite. Dr. Charles R. Wakeling Award is given in memory of Dr. Wakeling, is presented to a premier scholar athlete at RMHS for outstanding qualities in academics and athletics. This award goes to Matt Dinan. And the Boosters Club Virginia Bartlett Award is given in memory of a former teacher of physical education and staunch promoter of female athletics at Reading Memorial High School. Is presented to a premier scholar and athlete at Reading Memorial High School for outstanding qualities in academics and athletics. This award goes to Rachel Thompson. We are now honored to have Superintendent of Schools, Dr. John Doherty, with us to address the class.
Thank you, Mrs. Williams. Mr. Barker, school committee members, fellow administrators and faculty, family and friends of the graduates, students, other guests, and most importantly, members of the graduating class of 2015, it is my honor and privilege to address you today as you complete your graduation requirements and commence the next part of your journey. To begin my remarks, I am honored to announce this year's recipient of the Patrick A. Scatini Jr. Memorial Scholarship Award. This year, I have asked School Committee Vice Chair Jean Borowski to present the award to this worthy recipient. This award is given in memory of Superintendent of Schools Patrick A. Scatini Jr., to a graduate who exemplifies the qualities that he most cherished, a hardworking, high-achieving student, both within and beyond the classroom, who enjoys and excels in the STEM fields and embraces lifelong learning. The student selected this year is a leader among peers, very active in community service, and is a person passionate about physics and engineering. During her time here at Reading Memorial High School, she has participated in and has been a leader on the Reading Robotics Team, Operation Smile, and the Interact Club. She is presented at the Worcester Polytechnical Institute's annual Project Lead the Way Conference and has participated in the Women in Science and Engineering program. This student will be attending Bucknell University in the fall. It is with great pride that I present the Patrick A. Scatini Jr. Memorial Scholarship to Caitlin Mahoney. Caitlin is just one example of a student in your class who has made a difference during her time here at Reading Memorial High School. But there are many more of you who have positively contributed to our school community by finding your own unique pathways based on your interests, your values, and your passions. Here are a few of many examples. Janet Joy was born in Korea, could not speak English when she first arrived in the United States, took English as a second language class, and now finishes her high school career as a four-year member of the jazz band and has completed 8 advanced placement classes, the most ever by a Reading Memorial High School student. Sabine Michaud has been a quiet leader in the arts, excelling in the visual arts and performing as the stage manager for several shows during her 4 years in the Reading Memorial High School Drama Club. She is constantly led by example and has been the true glue behind the scenes of each drama production. Madison May chose to take a different path and enroll in online courses and participate in dual enrollment classes in order to fulfill her goal of traveling. She spent an entire month in Malaysia exploring another culture, and it has inspired her to pursue nursing, more specifically, healthcare for women worldwide. Jonna Lee has pursued her passion for a sense of justice by using her compassion and determination to educate our community on the issues that LGBTQ students face on a daily basis. Her presentation at our annual Education Institute in April on raising awareness in order to help educate and support students questioning their sexual identity was an inspiration to all who attended. Ian Brown has overcome significant medical issues, spending his early days in the Reading Public Schools managing his academics with his demanding dialysis and hospital clinic visit schedule. Successful transplant surgery in December of his sophomore year made finishing high school in 4 years a challenge, one that he met head-on and with success. Ian is going to major in political science and is currently serving as a member of Reading's town meeting. Charlie Kellogg. Charlie Kellogg has used his technical and theatrical talents through the RMHS Drama Club to model how to be true to yourself, help others recognize the importance of being proud of who you are, celebrate differences, and not hide behind what others call the norm. He has been a role model to his peers and staff at RMHS, as well as the Children in the Rise program, where he served as an intern this past year. And last but certainly not least, there's Caitlin Powers, who has struggled academically and emotionally since elementary school, but with the support and patience of many teachers at Killam, Parker, and the high school, along with her own will to succeed, completed college-level courses at North Shore Community College, and will graduate today as a proud young woman, thankful for all that have been offered to her in her time here. We also have two members of the class of 2015 that will be joining our armed forces. James Bedingfield will be attending the United States Military Academy at West Point, and Matthew Irwin will be joining the United States Army. All of these individuals, of course, are just a few examples of the many personal accomplishments represented here today. Each of you have found your niche and your talents and have made contributions to our school and to our community. You should be very proud of yourselves as a senior class, where you have been outstanding leaders and role models for the underclassmen. Collectively, this year alone, you have some amazing accomplishments. You've excelled on the athletic playing field with a state championship in girls ice hockey, 5 Middlesex League championships, and spring sports teams that are still in tournament competition. In addition, Matt Dinan won a state championship in the mile run, and Adam Morton won a state championship for his weight class in wrestling. You have shined in the visual and performing arts with 4 outstanding drama productions, a regionally recognized choral program, an award-winning jazz band, and Color Guard. Lauren Walsh has earned many awards for her outstanding work in photography, including 2 prestigious Gold Keys in this year's Scholastic Art and Writing Awards, and a National Gold Medal, which she will receive later this month at Carnegie Hall in New York City. In addition, our robotics team is among the best in the state, finishing strong and receiving the prestigious Entrepreneurship Award. And members of your class have also achieved academic success, with 16 National Merit Commended Scholars, and one of your classmates, Peter Satterthwaite, received recognition as a National Merit Scholar and was only one of only 14 students in Massachusetts who qualified for the prestigious United States Presidential Scholars Program. And finally, all of you deserve congratulations for completing the necessary graduation requirements to be here today. Class of 2015, please give yourselves a round of applause. Today, as you prepare for the next stage of your journey, my hope with my remaining remarks is simply to provide some possible compass points by which to navigate your way. As you may know, Rotary International is one of the largest community service organizations in the world, and their motto is service above self. I have had the privilege of serving as Reading's Rotary Club president this year, and some of you are also part of the Rotary-sponsored Student Interact Club, which has participated in many community service projects, and I've had the privilege of working with you as well. I think this organization's 4 key questions, called the 4-way test, may provide a possible compass to help us make decisions along our personal journeys and help us navigate the challenges that we face each and every day. The first question is it the truth? Although this seems obvious, the question is asking, are we being truthful and forthright with others without lying or being deceitful? The development of trust is one of the most important qualities you can have with your friends, your family, and your colleagues. Without trust, it is much more difficult to build relationships and move forward. One of the biggest obstacles to progress or compromise is the lack of trust between individuals. Be honest in your communication with others and follow this important principle. The second question is it fair to all concerned? When a decision is being made, does it hurt someone else? Are you letting your personal preferences get in the way of the greater good? Think back to when you were in kindergarten and you first learned and heard about the golden rule. This rule helped you learn the importance of treating others as you would like others to treat you. All too often, this rule is broken when we begin to judge people, particularly because of race, gender, sexual orientation, or because they are just different from us. When we make a decision, we need to make sure that those decisions do not hurt others. The third question is, will it build goodwill and better friendships? Each action that you take will have an impact on someone else. Be positive and cooperative with others, regardless of who they are or what they believe. Take the time and opportunities to build friendships with many different types of people. The collective strengths of many is greater than the individual strength of one. It is important to build those productive relationships and meaningful friendships that will last forever. And finally, the fourth question asks, will it be beneficial to all concerned? All too often, when decisions are made or actions are taken, only one side benefits. This can have a negative impact on a person or a group of people. Working together towards a common good eliminates unnecessary competition, which may hurt others. It reminds us to think and choose our words carefully, as once they are spoken, posted, tweeted, texted, or sent, they cannot be taken back. This compass point prompts us to think about what we are saying or writing is beneficial to all concerned. I want to give you a short example of how these four questions can guide a group's action. Recently in the news, you may have heard of school principal Courtney Bashow of the Profile Junior Senior High School in Bethlehem, New Hampshire, who told her students that she had been diagnosed with a rare form of aggressive cancer and that she would be out of school for a while. The students who had known Ms. Bashow for 6 years were devastated because they loved and respected the work that Ms. Bashow had done in leading their school. Unselfishly, the senior class, all 180 students, unanimously decided to give Ms. Bashow every dollar that they saved over the last 4 years to help defray her medical expenses as she fights this potentially deadly disease. The funds, over $8,000, were originally raised for their senior class trip to New York. When Ms. Bashow found out the news, she was emotional and said, "It is very hard for me to accept help, and I have no idea what to say." But the students said, "She's a very caring person, very selfless, and we wanted to be selfless too. Every one of us has a connection with her, and she's given so much to us that we just wanted to give back. She's one of the strongest, most determined women we know, and to see that happen to such a strong person." This generous act by a group of high school seniors is one example of how the four-way test can be applied to make a difference in this world. Soon, you will be starting your own new journey, a journey with unknowns and challenges, but also with hope and opportunities. The decisions you make will change your path many times. You may not always choose the most obvious path, and that's okay. However, if you use the four compass points of is it the truth, is it fair to all concerned, will it build goodwill and better friendships, and will it be beneficial to all concerned, your decisions may be easier to make. I challenge each of you to use the four-way test as your guide. Whether you are living away at school, commuting at school nearby, starting a new job, taking a year off, or joining the armed forces, these four simple questions can help you make good decisions, build strong and trusting relationships with others, and become successful no matter what you choose to do. So class of 2015, as you embark on the next chapter of your life, make your choices wisely. You are the leaders of tomorrow, who will guide our community, our country, and our world along its continued journey. What you've accomplished during the last 4 years at Reading Memorial High School has been remarkable, and your parents, your teachers, and other significant adults and friends have prepared you for the next steps. The decisions you now make may help solve the problems of tomorrow. On behalf of the parents, the educators, and the Reading community, I congratulate you on your graduation. I wish you good fortune, health, and happiness on your journey ahead. Thank you.
Thank you, Dr. Doherty. School Committee Chair, Mr. Charles Robinson, and former School Committee Chair, Mr. Chris Caruso, will now join me for the conferring of all diplomas. Please remember to hold your applause until all graduating seniors have received their diplomas. Nicholas Conrad Stevens. Alexandra Antoinette Sahagin. James Lloyd Beddingfield, Jr. John Gregory Bloom. Jenna Jisoo Choi. Michael Joseph D'Alessio. Rachel Nicole Denellen.
Yeah, Rachel!
Diana Lee. Brianna Morgan Leconte. Caitlin Mary Mahoney. Jonah Wilson Ogburn. Mary Catherine Amira. Matthew Joseph Pustizi. Alex James St. Pierre. Sonia Agarwal. Christian David Alexander. Michael Perry Algieri. Abigail Ann Alardi. Zachary Joseph Almeida. Carl Frederick Anderson the Fourth. Amanda Lynn Anthony. Pierce Anthony Ballantyne. Yoav Barkai. Megan Rose Berry. Jessica Bates. Shannon Nicole Bell. Emily Eleanor Benjamin. Woo! Alec Ray Bergeron. Emily Ann Berner. Claire Mary Bishop. Alyssa Margaret Bogosian. Sarah Catherine Bond. Zachary Bork. Kerry Michelle Bow. Megan Ann Bradley. Emily Ann Breen. Allison Haley Brown. Ian Charles Brown. Alexander Jonathan Bruckner. Nicole Buckley. Troy Burden. Hannah Elizabeth Byron. Courtney Ann Cadigan. Courtney Camello. Caitlin Caparelli. Annalisa Patricia Carbonito. Joshua Richard Caruso. Bradley Casa Lenovo. Matthew Thomas Cassavant. Emily Chen. Melissa Christine Clark. Reginald Terrence Claremont. Stephanie Reed Cohen. Kira Teresa Connolly. Anthony Michael Coppola. Kristen Elizabeth Corbin. Andrew Richard Costello. Cindy May Costello. Kerry Elizabeth Cody. Brian James Craven. Matthew Daniel Cronin. Amanda Beth Casado. Christina Beth Casado. Catherine Marie Daly. Joseph Michael DeBacco. Casey Jason DiLoretto. Catherine Grace DeMuzio. Ryan Matthew Da Silva. Jenny Esther Doxer. Nicole Michelle Doherty. Jennifer Christine Downey. William Snow Downing. Julia Ann Driscoll. Christopher James Didinsky. Hannah Catherine Dudley Youngs. Erin Marie Dunn. Matthew Francis Dinan. Sh- Shannon Emily Edson. Joshua Michael Erickson. Matthew Irwin. Vanessa Marie Espinola. Laurel Gail Evangelista. Abigail Rose Fargo. Brenna Elizabeth Farley. Matthew Edmund Ferraro. Tyler Robert Figenbaum. Emily Rose Fine. Matthew Riley Fisher. John Michael Flamia. Jill Foley. Robert Joseph Foley. Ryan Andrew Friedman. Karin Gadre. Nathan Thomas Giacalone. Liam Gillen Hughes. William Duncan Gillis III. Carrie Ann Gerard. Allie Patricia Gerard. Sarah Margaret Giuliano. Ryan Goodspeed. Connor Goodspeed. Aaron Robert Gray. Woo! Christopher James Guyon. John Radwick Hand. Kelsey Elizabeth Hardy. Paul Anthony Harrell. Morgan Amber Haynes. Julie Ann Herman. Colin Scott Hetherington. Ryan Parker Higgins. Madeline Therese Hollenbeck.
Yeah, Maddie!
Nicole Holtzberg Bell. Evan Lewis Howard. Melissa Huang. John Wendell Hubbard Jr. Elizabeth Marie Iacovello. Robin Mary Iantosca. Dorian Cruz Johnson. Drew David Johnson. Ryan Hanley Janeskis. Mary Elizabeth Jose. Natalie Ann Giuliano. Andrew Thomas Catchmar. Sophia Aphrodite Kalagiris. Timothy Francis Kane. Brooke Hope Keegan. Liam Thomas Keegan. Charlie August Kellogg. Michael John Keogh. Erin Jean Marie Kilbin. Griffin Brendan Killian. Aiden Kolinick. Bram Cools. Brian Kraft. Bailey Joseph Lanzalotta. Shaunine Lawrence. Brandon Lee. Jonna Clark Lee. Emily Helen Lerlasher. Molly Christine Lennox. Colin James Lewis. Megan Lorraine Littlehale. Kaylin Elizabeth Luby. Oscar Lopez. David Lukey. Nina Joyce Lukens. William Frederick Lynch IV. Haley Claire Macaluso. Ian McDonald. Casey Ann Mack. Megan Ann Mahoney. Grant Schneider Maitland. Casey Elizabeth Malinsky. Lily Manna. James Richard Marcusella. John Davis Maroney. Nick William McCafferty. Sean Patrick McCubbin. Emma Hart McDonough. Madison Ray McGrory. Brendan Robert McInerney. Molly Catherine McInerney. William McInerney. Annie Teresa McLaughlin. Stephen Michael McLaughlin. Matthew Searle McQueeney. John Meehan. Kaylin Patricia Melanson. Annalisa Melendi. Jamie Victoria Melly. Carly Marie Mello. Gerald William Muse. Matthew Dominic McCauley. Sabine Estelle Michaud. Christina Ann Mealy. Kate Lucy Magnosa. Yeah. Adam Morton. Victoria Evangelina Matola. Caitlin Ann Mundy. Catherine Mary Murphy. Owen Gerard Murphy. Taylor Nicole Murphy. William Joseph Murray. Sarah Michelle Musgrave. Emily Ann Narahara. Andrea Naomi Nastri. Courtney Brooke Naughton. Megan Mary Nelson. Michael Christopher Nelson. Meredith Ann Nestor. Amanda Nola. Simone Webster Norton. Megan Colleen O'Brien. Catherine Jean O'Donohue. Yeah! Megan O'Flaherty. Kelsey Ann O'Keefe. Megan Rose O'Shaughnessy. Robin Panariti. Joseph Anthony Papalardo. Olivia Pastori. Chirag Patel. Chirag. Zach Pelley. Joe William Penna. Denise Pereira. Evan Joseph Petrillo. Ashley Renee Piazza. Julia Lillian Popkin. Caitlin Nora Powers. Joseph Anthony Presho. Courtney Ann Quinlan. Nicholas John Rauchy. Michaela Noelle Reeves. Mackenzie Ray Regan. Jensen Reynoso. Emily Marie Ryan. Kendall Rebecca Richardson. Christopher Joseph Richmond. Adriana Marie Rizzo. Nicholas Paul Roche. Connor Patrick Rosenstein. Caitlin Magella Ryan. Margaret Ryan. Stephen John Ryan. Samantha Sabatino. Paul Sanford. Peter Satterthwaite. Kurt Christopher Schleter. Eric Safarian. Danielle Marie Siebold. Michael William Siebold. Shannon Elizabeth Siegel. Michael Aiden Senfuma. Sandra Ashley Scroy. Catherine Ann Schaefer. Kayla Elizabeth Szymanski. Natalie Marie Short. Rachel Rose Silva. Kiara Silva Lee. Catherine Summy Smith. Jiyoung Sun. Luis Miguel Sosa. Daniel Souza. Bridget Erin Stanford. Jessica Marie Saludo. Kiera Ann Stalecki. Carter Henry Sway. Samantha Irene Swan. Lauren Angela Swanson. Rebecca Ann Swanson. Derek Franklin Swindell. Yeah. Ashley Rose Tango. Laura Taylor. Crystal Tomaszewski. Rachel Thompson. Fallon Rose Tierney. Hannah Ray Trapini. Austin James Trubiano. Nicholas Richard Tucci. Ian Halsey Tucker. Amanda Lee Uglietta. Andrea Marie Uglietta. Carolyn May Vaness. Juliana Maria Vaquerano. Alances Emmanuel Vargas. Sean Patrick Verrier. Ashley Vino. Matthew Austin Vogelin. Samuel Thomas Wagner. Nathan Lee Walker. Lauren Kathleen Walsh. Rebecca Jane Wandell. Stephen West. Benjamin Isaac Westerman. Megan Catherine Whalen. Emily Whitehouse.
Megan.
Sydney Ann Wilworth. Althea Catherine Wolf. Perry Thomas Woodman. Erin Woods Murphy. Ryan Davis Wins. Leonard Zalm. Megan Rourke Ziegler. It gives me great pride to present to you the Reading Memorial High School Class of 2015.